And the factors to consider in a hire or lease contract will obviously vary depending on whatever it is that you intend to hire or to lease. So let's talk about some of the factors that you need to consider in these contracts. Okay, first of all, if you're new to this channel, welcome to Zeret Network. I'm Moses, and this channel is all about educational content, okay? So be it legal, you know, business related, development related, and all that stuff. So kindly be subscribed and hit the notification bell to be notified each time we put a new video. Also, if you know somebody who can benefit from these videos, do share the video with them. In short, help grow the channel, right? Now, let's talk about hire and lease contracts and things that you need to consider. A hire or lease contract is the kind of contract that gives you possession over something and the ability to use it without owning it, or basically without enjoying the rights that come with the ownership of the particular thing. So the idea is that you're going to be, you know, you want something, you want a car. So you have a choice, you can buy the car or you can hire the car. Either way, you get to drive the car. So that is a hire or a lease contract. But then, you know, you're just not going to be doing this. There are certain things you need to factor in as a business, okay? I mean, you need to factor those things in even if you're not a business, if you're just an individual. There are things you need to factor in. And what are these things? Number one, which one is better, hiring or leasing or just buying? Now, you have to look at the economic reality surrounding the entire thing. There are things that you're better off just leasing than hiring. Let's say you're a farmer, right? And now you need to use a combined harvester. So the question is, would you rather have your own combined harvester that you only get to use once, and or would you just hire one that you use that once, and that's pretty much it. So the economic reality surrounding the equipment or whatever it is that you intend to lease is important, or to buy, okay? So you have to ask yourself that. Which one is better? Should I buy it or should I just hire it? And how do I arrive at that answer? Well, what are the economic circumstances surrounding the thing? Remember, payment of regular monthly amounts might be preferred from a budgeting perspective to a single capital outlay. Number two, should you hire the asset or contract for the services? Again, sometimes it's not just a question of you using the thing. Sometimes what you need is not even the equipment. Sometimes what you need is the services. Okay, let's say these, right? Developing videos. Well, you have a choice. You can buy your own camera and then you can shoot and then you can edit. But what if it's just something that you want to create awareness? Do you really need to buy the camera? Or would you rather just hire a video production team? In fact, you don't hire the team, you contract for the services. You have them show up, do whatever they do. And, you know, that's pretty much it. So sometimes that is actually cheaper than buying the material involved or buying the equipment involved and running the entire cost. You know, again, you just have to look at the frequency at which you're going to be using those services. If it is just something that you're doing once, then it kind of just makes sense for you to lease or to hire the thing. Number three, what kind of risks transfer to you? While the hire or lease contract do not give you ownership of the asset, this does not mean that you get to possess the asset risks free. There's going to be some transfer of risk in the contract, and you need to know which kind of risks these are. So the contract sometimes is very clear on the kind of risks that are going to be transferred to the hire. For instance, you might be required to insure the equipment, okay? And so that is a cost that you're going to have to incur. Is the thing, if you're having a problem or if you're interested in finding out more about managing contractual risks, there's a course I did. It's part of my course on Skillshare or Udemy, whichever place you want to look it up. So there's going to be a link in the video description. Sign up, go through the course, a series of videos that will help you to understand risks associated with managing contracts, from the, you know, formation of a contract to issues to do with breach of contracts. How do you handle the breach? And what are the dangers of overreacting? All that stuff. Just, you know, check it out. Now, next, how is maintenance going to take place? Again, that is something that you need to factor in, okay? Yes, you have the equipment, you've chosen to hire it. How is the maintenance going to be handled? Is it going to be you? Is it going to be the company? Do you have a separate contract for that? Is that part of the contract that you've just got yourself into? I mean, you just can't be excited with the equipment. All these things will come at a cost. And so just like we said, what risks transfer to you, you also need to understand who's going to be in charge of maintaining the thing. Okay, like sometimes you get a bunch of photocopiers in the office, and then the company that supplies you photocopier still manages to handle the maintenance of the photocopier. Of course, you're going to pay for that. But if you don't want to pay for that and say you'll do it on your own, then that could mean contracting a different company to handle that. Okay, unless you have, depending on whatever it is that you've just hired, unless you have somebody in the organization who's good at maintaining it. So you kind of just have to figure out, okay, the thing about maintenance, who's going to handle it. Number next, is it possible to extend the scope of the contract? So again, what if the hire or the lease contract runs out and you're still interested in the services, okay? Is there a provision that you might actually be able to extend the scope? Or what if there is something in that contract that you need to be increased? Let's say you contracted to get 4 cars for the next 2 years, and then your work kind of increases and now you need car number 5. What happens? Okay, you need to hire or to lease car number 5. So how do you handle that? Does that mean that you have a new contract for just that one extra car? Or is there a provision to add the contract, to add the car into this the 4 that you already have? And then, you know, what happens? These are some of the things that you need to factor in. Number next, what if you want to reduce the scope of the contract? Yeah, sometimes you don't want to increase the number of cars. Sometimes you want to reduce it. I mean, I'm talking about cars because in the previous example, we talked about cars. What if you're, you know, like, you know, maybe the nature of business goes down and therefore you need to reduce the amount of cars that you're using, cut them back from 4 to maybe 2. How does the contract handle that? So that is something that you need to figure out in that contract from the get-go, okay? So again, remember, if you're interested in managing contractual risks, there's a link in the video description that will lead you to a series of videos handling that. So if there is any question, do let me know. I'm Moses from Zeret Network, and I'll see you in the next video.